Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome to Amazed by the Quran, a series in which I like to share with you things I find amazing about the Quran. Today I want to talk to you about two prophets again. Both of them talked about in Surah Al-A'raf, the seventh surah. One of them is Hud and the other one is Nuh alayhi salam. Talking about Nuh alayhi salam in the same surah, Allah says, قَالَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ إِنَّا لَنَرَاكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. The chiefs, the generals, or you could even say Mala is the elite of his people, said that we see you obviously lost. We consider you lost or confused. So Allah is making a comment about the elite of Nuh's time, that they were at the forefront of making propaganda against Nuh. Okay, so that's the first prophet, and the chiefs are the elite of that time making propaganda. The second case is that of Hud. And again, the elite are highlighted. قَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ إِنَّا لَنَرَاكَ فِي سَفَاهَةٍ وَإِنَّا لَنَظُنُّكَ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ. The chieftains, the elite, who had disbelieved from among his people, said that we certainly see you immersed in stupidity, ma'adallah, and we consider you from those who lie. Okay, so now, in both cases, the elite are, in a sense, pointed at. And the accusatory fingers pointed at them, right? They're the ones incriminated. But the interesting language is قَالَ الْمَلَأُ as opposed to قَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. The chiefs from his people, or the elite from his people on the one hand, and the elite who disbelieved from among his people on the other hand. Allah is actually making a distinction between the struggles of both of these prophets, and he's alluding to the fact that Nuh alayhi salam had the toughest time of all other prophets. That's why, about his nation, وَقَوْمَ نُوحٍ مِّن قَبْلِ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا هُمْ أَظْلَمَ وَأَطْغَى وَالْمُؤْتَفِكَةَ أَهْوَى. Allah describing them in another place in the Quran says, the Nuh's people before, they in fact were they were more wrongdoing and more rebellious than anybody else. Like the worst nation described in the Quran is the nation of Nuh. Okay? So, and there's a reason for that. You know that you can have a qualitative problem and a quantitative problem. The persistence with which they did crimes, right? The centuries and centuries and centuries labels them, qualifies them for the label of the worst nation, okay? Or the worst enemies of a prophet. In any case, Allah is saying, making a blanket statement about the elite in the nation of Nuh and saying the chiefs among them said, we see you as confused. But when it came to Hud, he didn't say the chiefs, the elite, basically, brushed him off. He said, the elite who had disbelieved among them. So he qualified the elite. So he didn't even take all of the elite and throw them under the bus, if you will. Right? So what we're learning here is that you might have people in political power, in economic power, in social standing that may become proponents against Islam and speak ill of it, etc. But you cannot use even them to make categorical statements about all wealthy people, all politicians, all leaders, all heads of states, etc., etc., etc. You can't generalize. Allah gave license for Nuh alayhi salam's case for that to be generalized because that's centuries in the making. It's been cooking for a long time. In the case of Hud alayhi salam, no. الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. The qualification was necessary. This is yet again the Quran's remarkable way of teaching people to think in more sophisticated ways. To not oversimplify things. To not just take your and my frustration about, oh, all those politicians, they're all the same. You heard this, right? All politicians, they're all the same. Well, Quran doesn't let you say that. The Quran doesn't let you say that. The Quran is basically saying you have to be careful about how you how you label people. There were those who explicitly expressed their disbelief and their disregard for the Prophet, and they came after him, calling him stupid and saying ma'adallah, calling him stupid or saying that he's among those who lie. They made propaganda against him. Yes, watch out for those, but don't dismiss all the others or assume insincerity on their part. May Allah Azza wa Jal keep us from those who paint with broad strokes and look at life and look at people around us with more subtlety and more care. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.